The great protector, is that what I'm supposed to be? What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be. What if by that time I realize it's too far behind to see? 70 mil projector, I can show you everything, yeah. And we're on our way to glory, where the show won't ever end, and the encore lasts forever, and it's time we do the spin. Spending the years together, growing older every day. I feel at home when I'm around you, and I'll gladly say again, I hope the encore lasts forever. Now this time we're due to spend. And it's sublime with you, my friend. This right here still feels like the honeymoon when you say my name. Nothing's changed, I'm still a boy inside my thoughts. Am I meant to understand my fall? I don't think so. I don't think I'm meant to understand myself. Maybe you do. That's good for you. Maybe in time, maybe one day, I'll do the same. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough. Old enough to understand.
Guys, it is Junebug here, and tonight we're going to be doing a tutorial for Rex Orange County song called Pluto Projector. I've been meaning to do a tutorial for this for a while now, but, you know, I've been saying I'm going to do a video, but I never will. But I'm doing it! So, stay tuned. We're going to go over the whole thing. It's a pretty long song to learn, but I feel that it's really fun to learn how to play on ukulele, and then you can really impress your friends if you learn how to play the whole thing. But anyways, let's get started. Okay guys, so like most of my videos, everything is in standard tuning. Okay, and then we're gonna go over everything slowly but surely. So the first chord you're gonna learn how to play is a C. Open, 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 three. Okay, the next chord is a E minor, which is open, four, three, two. Okay, and the next chord after that is gonna be an F, but this F is gonna be two, open, one, three. Okay, next chord you're gonna learn how to play, I think this is a D or a D minor, I don't know, but it's two, two, one, open. And then remember this, we're going to do a little rendition of the D, of that D minor or something. It's going to be 2-2-1, and then you're sneaking your pinky right on that 2 at the last string. So 2-2-1-2. Okay? Alright, the last two, or the last chord is going to be a rendition of the G, which is open 2-3-2. Remember that, and then we also have another version of the D of the G. Sorry, is open 2-3-3. Because I'm going to be like this. And those are most of the chords for like the really simple parts of the song. So, anyways, the intro is going to be like this. You do that. I played the chords in order, but it's going to go C. The great protector, is that what I'm supposed to be? Going to E minor. Okay, and then if you've seen my other videos, I do the same kind of like plucking pattern. So there's not really a strum pattern to this, like down, down, up, up, down, up, down. It's just me learning how to use my thumb and my index finger, right? And then I'm just learning the same strumming pattern. So what I'm doing is I'm strumming down a long strum, and then usually if I hit the same strings correctly, which you don't have to do because no one's going to notice the difference, I do down and then hit this string, the first string, and then with my pointer finger I flick up the last string, then the third string. So. So as long as you practice this, so. And then if you do it faster and faster, like. All you have to do is put your fingers on the chords, and then it'll sound really good, like. Okay? So that's a little explanation. I'll go slower if you want me later, but okay, so we're going back to the intro. It is a C. The great protector, is that what I'm supposed to? And then you're going to E minor. B. So this part, you're doing it about four times. So that'll be for each chord. So. Great protector, is that what I'm supposed to be? And then you go to the E minor. Is that what I'm supposed to be? I'll go slower. And then you're going to that F, which is 2, open, 1, 3. What if all this counts for nothing? What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be. What if... Okay, this part, we're gonna cut it into two, where we're doing two times this minor chord, which is 2-2-1 open. And then... So we're going to that other chord that I taught you, 2-2-1 open.
What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be. What if by the time I realize?
So you're going like, oh sorry, you're going once. And then you're going to the new chord. Okay, so you're just only playing it once because you're doing the last two chords is gonna be that minor chord and then going to the G. So right after the F.
What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be.
Then right here.
What if by the time I...
Then you sneak your pinky.
Realize.
Okay. And the next chord after that is that weird G, which is open, 2-3-2. Or open, 2-3-3, my bad. So. And then you're going to the normal G, which is open, 2-3-2. Okay? So that was really fast, so let me break it down. So that last part's the most confusing part, so. Right here.
The great protector. Is that what I'm supposed to be? What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be.
And then right here, I'm not gonna sing. It's gonna go like this. So you're splitting it up 2-2, but each time you're doing a rendition of that chord. So 2-2-1, open, then 2-2-1-2, and then you're going to that G, which is open 2-3-3, and then the normal G, open 2-3-2. So let's start with that F.
What if by the time I realize it's...
Oh, wait.
What if all this counts for nothing? Everything I thought I'd be. What if by the time I realize it's too far behind to see?
Nice. And that's mostly it. And then you sing it again.
70 mil projector.
See?
I can show you everything.
Don't forget the yeah.
Yeah. And we're on our way to glory, where the show won't ever end.
And right here.
And the encore lasts forever, and it's time we do the Spendin.
Okay, so right after that, we're with the weird chords. So right here, you play an F, which is that 2, open, 1, 3.
Where the encore lasts forever, and it's time we do the Spendin.
Okay, so let's break that down. So I do the F right here, and then... The strumming pattern or the plucking pattern is going to be a little bit different. If you hear the song, it goes like... So, what I did, the F, and then the third string, then the second, then the last. So, and then you do this third, then the second, then the third, so. Okay, so just remember that. And then right after that, you hear a little. And all you're doing is putting your ring finger on the 4th fret on the 2nd string, and then the 3rd fret on the next string over on the 3rd fret, and then like, so the 3, then 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, so all together you're doing like this. And the encore lasts forever, now this time we're doing, I'll go slow. So, let's go slow. Okay, and then the last, and then the chord after that is kind of an, I think it's an F minor chord. And this chord is 1 open 1 3. And then you're just plucking that leg. So, again, a little bit confusing, but we'll break that down, so. So I'm kind of like mimicking this like, but when I'm playing it, I'm just strumming out this chord, that F minor. And you don't have to pluck the string perfectly, like whatever string that I'm plucking. You can do like, or like, it doesn't matter. So, again, and then F minor. So in that case, this is what I did the last part. So, but sometimes I go like this, or like, it doesn't matter. As long as you follow that. So you're just alternating between the like the strings. Does that make sense? Everyone gets confused, but I feel like it's kind of simple. It's just very hard for me to slow down and then teach you. So again, we'll go over it again. I'll sing that last part. 70 mil projector, growing older every day. Yeah? I feel at home and I'm around you, and I'll gladly say again, right here, I hope the encore lasts forever, now there's time we're due to spend. My bad. So, and then right after that, you just go on with the next verse. Spending the years together, growing older every day. So I feel like that transition part is kind of like the most confusing because it doesn't go with like the normal rhythm or plucking of it, but like as long as you understand, like this part I play always the same like this, and then that 3-4-3-4, and then that F minor. You can do whatever you want for that F minor though, or like whatever you want, as long as you follow like a kind of like that. So again, just practice. Let's go slow.
Spending the years together, growing older every day.
I think I just sang the lyrics wrong in the previous, like, minute, but whatever. I feel at home when I'm around you, and I'll gladly say again, I hope the encore lasts forever, and it's time we're due at the span. And it's the one with you, my friend. So right here, instead of this, you just start strumming it. So like, and it's, and I hope the encore lasts forever. I'll just play it and see what I do. Oh, okay, so I literally do the same strumming pattern, like. So, right here, this. So you just learn that first part where you do the F. And then I just do my strumming pattern after that. And it's sublime with you, my. And then you go to the F minor. Friend. You can do that. And it's sublime with you, my. Or you can just do downstrokes. Friend. Okay. So there's just like lots of opportunities. But as long as you practice, it'll sound good. It'll sound like it transitions very well. So, spending years together, blah, blah. And it's, and the encore lasts forever. Now this time we're due to spend. Oh my, and it's sublime with you, my friend. So you're doing the same chords for the next part as the, you know, verses and stuff, but instead I'm just downstrumming. So
this right here still feels like the honeymoon when you say my name. Nothing's changed, I'm still a boy inside my thoughts. Am I meant to understand my fault?
And then right here, that G, I just stop right here, cause like there's that part where it's silent, sorry. And then like,
I don't think so.
So let's go over that again. We'll start from the sublime with you, my friend part. So
I hope the encore lasts forever. Now this time we're due to spend. And it's sublime with you, my friend. This right here still feels like the honeymoon when you say my name. Nothing's changed, I'm still a boy inside my thoughts. Am I meant to understand my thoughts? I don't think so, I don't think so, I don't think I'm meant to understand myself.
Same thing, you're doing this. Okay, so.
Maybe you do, that's good for you. Maybe in time, maybe one day.
And then right here, instead of doing the strumming pattern, I kind of start downstroking, because like I'm building up to that last part. So
maybe in time, maybe one day.
Then I'm downstroking.
I'll do the same.
Just downstrokes. then this is the cool part. So let's go over that again. After the I don't think so. So you start right on the so. I don't think so. I don't think I'm meant to understand myself. Maybe you do. That's for good. That's good for you. Maybe in time, maybe one day, I'll do the same. It's actually a really easy song to play, as long as you remember the lyrics and stuff, and as long as you remember the chords. But this part might be challenging, so we'll go over it though. F. Okay. Ready?
I'll do the same. I'll do the same. I'll do the same.
I do the same as you, I try to hold it up. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough. Alright, let's break that down. Okay, so it's gonna be doing this twice. The first time you're just playing it. So, I'll do the same, I'll do the same, I'll do the same. Okay, and then the second part, you're actually singing with it, which took me some time to like practice, but I know how to do it now, so I bet you can too.
I do the same as you, I try to. I do the same as you, I try to hold it up. Soon I hope, oh, as soon as I'm old enough.
Okay, let's break that down. So the first part I do is an F, a normal F, two open, one open. And then I'm strumming it out, and then I'm hitting a third, then the second, then the last. So, and then I would say, you know how I told you, like, you can hit any chord or any string you want as long as it's on the chord. In this case, this solo part, I would try to stick with playing the right strings. So it sounds more like a solo that you can repeat over and over again and stuff. So you'll get what I mean when I start playing the other part too. So you got your F, then 3, 2, 4. And then this next chord is like an A chord, but it's 2, 1, 3, open. Okay? So what I do, F, then that A, the weird A. So what I do right here, I do A, and then what I do is, so I lift my ring finger, so I have an open string on that third string. So I let it strum, then I hit the third string, but I lift up my ring, and then I hit the second string, and then I put my finger back on that third fret, and I hit that third string, so. Okay? It takes some practice, because this part, I was like, oh my god, my fingers don't seem to be working, but trust me, 2, 1, 3, and then you're lifting this, so. So, F, then that weird A, put it back, okay, and then this D minor, or I think this is a D sharp minor, or something like that, but 2, 2, 1, open. So I'm strumming it up, but I'm hitting 2nd, 3rd, 4th, so. And then the next chord is a D, which is 2-2-2 open. And then I'm doing the same thing as the last one, 2-3-4. I'm plucking those strings. Okay? So let's break that down. Okay, you got your F first. And then you're going F, 3-2-4. Okay? Then that weird A. Oh, lift it. 3. Second string. Put it back down. Third string. So. And then you got your D sharp minor, I think. And then 2-3-4. And then you got your D. 2-3-4. So. It's starting to sound better when you play it fast. Okay, the next chord is, I think this is an A sharp, but I don't know. 3-2-1-1. And then when you're doing this, you're gonna do strum, third string, second string, fourth. So. Okay. And then the next chord is 3-1-1-1, which is, I think, an A sharp minor. 3-1-1-1. Same strumming pattern, so 3-2-4. So and then the last chord is an F, but you're putting your pinky on the 3, so 2-open-1-3. But you're gonna do that last, so. So you're putting, or you put your pinky or your ring finger, and then you're strumming the chord out, which is a normal F. And then third string, second string, and then put your ring finger, sneak it right on that 3 on the last string, and hit that. So, last part. Then the F. Okay, you got that? Let's put it all together. Okay, so you got your F. That weird A. D sharp minor. Then D. Then 3-2-1-1. Then 3-1-1-1. Normal F, and then sneak that ring finger. You got it? I'll do the same as you would try to hold it up. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough. And then when you start to learn how to play faster. I'll do the same as you would try to hold it up. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough. If you do it fast,
I'll do the same. I'll do the same as you would try to hold it up. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough.
Okay, so again, with practice and stuff, that's when you slowly start to get better and better. It took me like, I'd say like 2-3 days for me to start like learning this song and stuff, but it might take you longer, but I promise you it'll be worth it. So after you do this, and then this is the part with the strings and stuff, so okay, so first chord is you bar your pointer finger on the 5, 5, 5, and then 6, 5. Okay, and then what I'm doing is strumming, third string, second, then fourth. So, okay, next string, or next chord is 5, 4, 5, 3. Okay. And then same thing. Third, second, fourth. So. Next chord, 5, 4, 5, 3. And then all you have to do is move it 2 frets up. 3, 2, 3, 1. Same thing. Strum it. Third, second, fourth. So. And then this last string, or this last chord, is going to be, you're just going to play the last 3 strings. But it's 2, 1, 2. So after this, just the last 3 strings. And then you're doing 2nd, 3rd, 4th. So, and then string, and then 2, 1, 2. Okay, so let's break that down again. You got that 5, 5, 6, 5. Then 5, 4, 5, 3. Again, the same kind of plucking pattern, which is 3rd, 2nd, 3rd, 2nd, 4th. Swing it all the way up. And then this weird chord, 2, 1, 2. And then this next chord is a 8, 7, 6, 6. And then same as the like normal, 3rd, 2nd, 4th. Next is, it's gonna be 8, 6, 6, 6. So it's really easy, so you're just moving your finger right here, and then you're barring it, so. And then, which is, yep, 8, 6, 6, 6. So, same thing, 3rd, 2nd, 4th, and then this last chord is going to be kind of like the same as like the first chord that I taught you, but it's going to be, you're going to put your ring finger right here on the 7, so 7, 5, 6, 5. And then instead, when you're hitting that 4th string, you're gonna sneak your pinky right over here on the 8. So again, 7, 5, 6, 5. And then you're doing the same strumming pattern. 3rd, 2nd, and then you're sneaking your pinky right over here on that 8 on the last string. So again, that last 3 parts, so. Then right here. Okay, so let's do that again. So 5, 5, 6, 5. 5, 4, 5, 3. 3, 2, 3, 1. block the first, 2-1-2. And then 8-7-6-6. 8-6-6-6. Seven, five, six, five. But then sneak in that pinky at the on the eight. And then you're gonna play this a few times. So the first time, and then you're going here. And then you're right here.
Old enough to understand.
And you're playing it again. And then you go a little bit after, right here.
Old enough to understand.
Playing again. The strings are getting louder. And then you're gonna play it one more time to its full thing. And then this last part, all you're doing is doing that last part like two more times. So then you're going back to the 8-7-6-6, 8-6-6-6, then, and then you're going to do it one more time. And then you're going to play the outro after that. So. And then the outro.
Stay forever.
Okay, so let's go over that really slow. I'm just gonna go really slow. You can rewind this and watch this video as long, as many times as you want, but we're gonna do it one more time. So.
Maybe I'm there. I'll do the same. I'll do the same.
Is it focused, man? Wonder, huh? I gotta do this more in the like daytime, but I'm sorry, guys.
I'll do the same. I'll do the same.
I'll go slower.
I'll do the same.
Sorry.
I'll do the same. Do the same as you, I try to hold it up. Soon I hope, or as soon as I'm old enough.
Here comes the fun part.
Old enough to understand.
You want me to go slower? I'll go slower.
Old enough to understand.
Oops. Play with one more time in its entirety. And then you're gonna play that last part like twice, so. one more time, but you're going to transition to the outro. Stay forever, you know more than... Okay, so you're almost there. Almost there, guys, come on. All right, these last chords, it's going to be the same plucking pattern that I've been teaching you, okay? This first chord is 3-2-1-1, which is an A sharp. Stay forever, you know more than anyone. Just an F, 2 open, 1 open. One, yeah. And it's, this next chord is a, I think it's a D sharp, which is 3-3-3-1. And it's you that knows my darkness, and you know my bedroom needs. And then this part is a little bit different. This is my thing that I do for my version of it, but it sounds really cool. You can bless me and my secrets, but there's probably just no need. Okay, so this, the first chord, I'm doing like this, and then lifting it. So this first chord is 3-4-3-5. You can bless me and my... And then the next chord, you're just lifting up your ring finger, which is 3-4-3-3. So. You can bless me and my secrets. And then you're going back to that 3-3-3-1, which is the D sharp. But there's probably just no... And then this last chord, you're ending it on a... You're not really playing this first string, but 3-2-1. So, but there's probably just no need. Okay, so that last part, again, you got that 3-4-3-5. You can bless me and my secrets. And then 3-3-3-1. But there's probably just no need. Mute it, 3-2-1. And let it ring out. So I'll just play the entirety. Stay forever. You know more than any F1. Yeah. Whoa. Oh. Then 3-3-3-1. And it's you that knows my darkness, and you know my bedroom needs. You can bless me and my secrets, but there's probably just no need. And that's the whole song. Yay, great. Yay, hooray, hooray, hooray. Okay, guys, so that is the whole tutorial for the song Pluto Projector. It's a really long tutorial, but just know that I put a lot of thought into this song. So it's not just that normal four chord song that you just play over and over again. I really did put like some intricacies in there, so it sounds like a real song that like maybe a professional would learn how to play, but also a beginner slash normal person like me or you can learn how to play on its own. Again, it takes a lot of time to memorize everything, especially that intro. And there's a lot of chords, but I swear once you start practicing and learning how to transition from one spot to the other, you start building it into, you're starting to fit the puzzle pieces together, and then it becomes the whole masterpiece, which is the song. So if you guys have any questions, I will try to answer them as best as I can. Look out for more videos. I promised myself I would do more videos and stuff, but I don't know, I'm just like really tired and lots of stuff, kids and stuff and chores and everything else, but I will try my best to reply back to you, to do more videos in the future, to answer your questions, and I really do appreciate you guys watching my videos. They're really long, but I swear it'll be worth it in the end if you really put the effort and the time into learning how to play these songs. But good night, everyone. Till next video, this is Junebug. Bye, guys.